Next chapter is your shear strength of soil. Coulomb 1773, shear strength given C plus sigma n ton phi. So, then it has been modified by Coulomb and our slave shear strength. S is equal to C prime sigma prime tan phi prime. C prime is equal to effective soil cohesion, sigma is equal to normal stress, sigma prime is equal to effective normal stress. So, for cohesive soil, so this is C and this will be phi, this is S, this is sigma. So, generally for cohesive soil, discontinuity or the pre-consolidation pressure. let us start with this new chapter, shear strength of soil. So, initially shear strength of soil was means given by this Coulomb 1773, shear strength S is equal to C plus sigma n tan phi, C is equal to soil cohesion or sigma n is your stress, normal stress. Then later on it has been modified by Coulomb and Harslev for the shear strength. They have considered S is equal to C prime and sigma prime. C prime is your effective soil cohesion and sigma prime is your effective normal stress, which is equal to normal stress minus this pore water pressure. So, generally for this if I draw the more failure of envelope of this Mohr Coulomb, generally 3 Mohr Coulomb, 3 tests required to plot the Mohr Coulomb. So, it is a typical diagram it is I am drawing. So, this is generally the failure envelope is a non-linear. So, it has been approximated as a linear one. So, from there the intercept line, the draw the three Mohr Coulomb, then from there draw a common tangent, draw a common tangent where it passes intercept this shear strength axis, that is your C, that gives your C or unit cohesion, and this angle of this with this horizontal dash give phi. Phi is equal to angle of internal friction, phi is equal to angle of internal friction. Now, in case of pre-consolidated soil, there is a discontinuity while plotting this shear strength of the soil from this Mohr circle. The discontinuity observed at pre-consolidation pressure. Once if sigma is your overburden normal overburden pressure is less than your pre-consolidation pressure. So, at that time it will be kind of asymptotic or maybe it is one straight line. At this point there is a breakage, it will go in this direction. So, there is a distinguished discontinuity at the pre-consolidation pressure. I can say if this is my PC, so this to this will be your is indicating sigma is less than PC, and this to this it indicates sigma is greater than PC. Now, once you draw a Mohr circle, if it is a total stress, now this effective stress and total stress come into picture. Here it is a total stress, S is equal to C plus sigma tan phi, it is a total stress, and this is an effective stress principle where this modified Coulomb's theory. Then what does it mean if I draw a Mohr circle, draw the Mohr circle and draw the tangent, this is case of a total stress. The moment I say it is effective stress, what will happen? The sigma prime will be sigma minus u, normal stress minus this pore water pressure whatever it is coming. That means if this is my sigma, so this part will be, this will be my, this will be, this part will be u pore water pressure or maybe delta u change in pore water pressure. So, sigma minus delta u and this part will be your, this will be your sigma prime and this will be your sigma. So, from sigma minus sigma prime it is your sigma minus delta u, it is your sigma prime, that is your effective normal stress. Once I plot total stress and effective stress, if you look at this effective stress, this curve is skewed, it will go slowly like this, it will skewed, and at that point this intercept of this C cohesion parameter, C parameter will goes down. So, if I draw this is my total stress, definitely effective stress will be towards this left or towards this axis of unit cohesion parameter. So, here one case is your total stress, other typical case I plot it for your effective stress, generally this diagram is for normally consolidated clay. Now come back to what are the different, before you go in detail of shear strength, what are the different laboratory tests required to find it out the shear strength parameters. So the laboratory tests are means test to determine the shear strength parameters. So A is your unconfined compression test, B is your direct shear test, C is equal to triaxial test. Now, these are the three tests generally we conduct in the laboratory to find it out shear strength parameters. So, shear strength, what are the shear strength parameter? One is your C, other is your phi, or it may be, or it may be C prime, or it may be a phi prime in terms of effective. So, these are the three tests generally conducted to find it out your shear strength parameters. Generally, what happened? The sample size, soil sample size generally provided, generally prepared, this ratio is 1:2. 1:2 means the if diameter is 38, so it will be 76. So, what is the reason? This sample preparation in the laboratory, it should be L by D should be greater than 3 and greater than 2 and less than 3. Why? What is the reason? Why? What is the reason that sample has been prepared with 1:2 ratio? And main reason is, one reason is during test the sample should not buckle. Then second part of here is failure plane doesn't intersect, failure plane doesn't intersect the loading heads. The basic reason, this sample size, if this is my L, if this is my D diameter, so the ratio should be greater than 2, greater than equal to 2 and less than 3. Generally the sample size available in the laboratory, so it will be 38/72 or 50/100 or 100/200 or 200/400. What does it mean if I say 50/100? That means diameter is equal to 50 mm and length is equal to 100 mm. This is the ratio generally we keep it in the laboratory preparing the sample. Then it should, why it has been made up to this? So, this sample while loading, it should not fail by means of buckle. Buckling failure should not occur. The second reason is the failure plane, because the sample should fail by shear, this failure plane should be within the soil sample. The failure plane should not extend beyond the soil sample or interact with this loading frame. If this is my loading frame, so that means this failure plane should be within this soil sample and it should not extend or interact with your loading frame. These are the two reasons why the sample size has been kept into 1:2 ratio. Now, after the preparation of soil sample, is over. These are the three tests. One is your unconfined compression test, second is your direct shear test, and third is your triaxial test. Now, start with case 1, unconfined compression test. Now, in this case, it is called, sometimes it is called unconsolidated undrained test. Just drawing this diagram for more explanation. Now, see, in unconfined compression test, the sample has nothing, only a vertical load, a stress has been applied in vertical direction. So, there is no confinement. Unconfined means there is no confinement around the periphery. That means there is no confinement around the periphery. Sample has been applied, a stress in vertical directions. If I look at this failure envelope, means how the sample will go, it will only compress in vertical direction. That's it. There is no confinement. So what will happen? Initially A 0, area whatever is there, so it will be a distorted A. Because of this, it will be distorted. Whatever the area for cross sectional area is will be there, it is my diameter. This new diameter will be d 1. So, change in length will be delta L. So, total length after the test is over, it will be delta L, L minus delta L. Sometimes this is called unconsolidated undrained test. That means sample has been taken, simple sample has been taken, and with this pedestal, means whatever the loading frame is available, with this loading frame, the sample, soil sample, simply erect it in the or put it in the loading frame. Then with this loading frame, with the help of proving ring, strain means with the help of proving ring, constant rate of strain or stress, maybe stress control as well as strain control can be done. So, once the soil sample is there, look at there, this is my simple diagram loading frame. So, then by means of dial gauge, you can measure your what is the vertical displacement. That means there is no confinement around the soil sample, even the ground surface. Why it is called unconsolidated, undrained? If this is my ground surface, within the ground surface, below the ground surface, if I collect the soil sample, before collection of the soil sample, it will be acted by vertical as well as lateral pressure. That means, here in this test, the confinement lateral pressure is 0. Only this stress has been applied by means of vertical with the help of probing ring. So, the only difference is that it will be load applied without confinement, that is why it is called unconfined. And at this stage, no consolidation process is there, no consolidation is there. Simple soil sample has been taken and put it in the pedestal. And load has been applied by means of stress has been applied by constant rate of by means of probing ring with constant rate of displacement method, or maybe stress control, it is a strain control, maybe stress control, maybe strain control. So, there is no confinement, no lateral pressure, no consolidation. So, that is why sometimes it is called unconsolidated, undrained. That means there is no drainage. So, in this case the displacement occurred by means of vertical stress is in the vertical direction. So, it is a very simple test to get very quickly. So, delta sigma 1 is equal to P by A. Stress coming to here will be load applied divided by cross sectional area. Now, volume of the sample, but at the same time volume of the sample will remain constant. So, A 0 L 0 is equal to A prime L 0 minus delta L. With this strain, which is equal to delta L by L 0. Now, look at this, there is volume of the sample is constant, remains constant. So, stress when once you apply this load P, the stress will be P by A. Now, initially the volume is A0 area into L 0. Once it is get distorted, so this is my modified area because diameter changes, L 0 minus delta L. So, it will be L 0 minus delta L, this is the length it is remaining. So, how much is your strain coming? Strain is your change in length by original length. So, change in length strain is your, this is your delta L, by original length is your L 0. Now, A prime, if I equate it to this, A prime is equal to A 0 L 0 by L 0 minus delta L. So, it will be in terms of if I write it, it will be in terms of modified area which is equal to A 0 initial area minus change in strain. That means, once you are applying, suppose you apply a 1 kg or maybe 1 kilonewton per meter square of the stress or 1 kg load, what is the displacement you observe, find it out, how much is your modified area A prime. Then you apply another 2 increase, find is your modified area. That means, it is a continuous, that means change in strain you will find it out. Change in stress you will find it out P by A. This A will be always this A will be, as the test progress, it will be A prime. That means for a particular strain, you will find it out how much is your delta sigma 1, say strain 2, xi 1, this is your xi 1, this is your xi 2, then this is your xi 3, it will be delta sigma 1, delta sigma 2, then delta sigma 3. With this reading, whatever you are getting with this reading, you plot your delta sigma, means stress versus strain. Stress versus strain diagram, you plot it. So, once you plot it, stress versus strain diagram, this is the diagram you are supposed to get. As there is no confinement, so the stress versus strain, initially it will be elastic, then it will goes to plastic, then fails, then it will decrease. So, the peak failure, where it will go peak and decrease, that point, in that case it is taking as a, we are taking as a failure point. So, this is your QU, ultimate strength. Now, if I draw the Mohr circle, that means if I draw the Mohr circle, shear strength versus sigma, what will case in this case? So, Mohr circle is a plot of sigma. If this is my sigma 1 and this is my sigma 3, so what will happen to sigma 3? As there is no lateral, direction, there is no pressure. So, that means sigma 3 is equal to 0. That means here sigma 3 is equal to 0. So, from where you will get your sigma 1? Whatever the failure from here, delta sigma by strain, means stress by strain, wherever your peak you are getting, that is your sigma 1. So, you put it your sigma 1. So, if I draw a Mohr circle, so it will pass through the origin. Now, from here, this point, this is your shear strength, C is equal to Q u by 2. If you draw a tangent, this tangent will be parallel to or asymptotic or parallel to your sigma axis, then shear strength C is equal to Q u by 2. So, this is the case how you are going to get particularly your shear strength, means here shear strength is C is equal to Q u by 2, and in this case the Mohr circle will pass through your origin O as sigma 3 is equal to 0. So, it will pass through the origin O, and sigma 1 you are getting for getting from stress versus strain diagram, from the peak value you will get your sigma 1. Now, next step you are coming, this is a case first test, this is called unconfined compression test. That means, it is not confined, unconfined compression test. Sometimes it is called quick test. How far this test is required, as far as geotechnical engineering is concerned, how the test is required to us? As this is called a quick test, you can bring soil sample from the field, undisturbed soil sample. Immediately in a compression machine, you put the soil sample. Immediately you get an idea, particularly what is your shear strength. Remember, this unconfined compression test is possible particularly for cohesive soil. If it is a cohesionless soil, in that case the soil cannot stand. The soil cannot stand by its own weight. So, this test is applicable for particularly cohesive soils, where the soil sample you can take out. If I leave the soil sample, it can stand by its own weight. What does it mean? From field, if I take out the soil sample, if put it in a flat surface, so the soil will stand, it will not fail. But if you bring the cohesionless soil, cohesionless soil means sand, can you put a sand so that it can stand? No. In cohesionless soil, sand will fall, so it is not possible. So, this is particularly for cohesive soils. So, you bring it, immediately within an hour, you finish your test. That means, you will get some behavior which is related to unconsolidated undrained. This is called quick test. Unconsolidated undrained. Now you are saying that unconsolidated undrained, where it is applicable in real field, where it is applicable, where is that condition is exist? That means if somebody says this is unconsolidated undrained, unconsolidated undrained means consolidation is not there as well as shearing also is not there. For example, construction of an embankment, during construction what happened? Suppose you have taken a soil sample, taken soils nearby pit, you construct this embankment by stages. By stages, if you construct this embankment, what will happen? Once you construct this embankment by stages, what will happen? Immediately, what is its strength? That means, once you take soil sample from pit, and compact it layer by layer, within no time, this is not going to be consolidated. This will be remain unconsolidated. Then within the time, immediate effect, drainage is also not possible. So that case, while during this construction, what is the strength parameter? During construction, what is your strength parameter if somebody asked? Then in that case, it will correlate to your quick test or unconfined compression test. Similarly, this is embankment. Similarly, road construction, so in case of road construction, subgrade material, immediately you put it and compact it, you want to know, once the compaction has been done, how much, what is your strength? What is your strength of that particularly material? It may be sand, it may be clay, it may be silty clay. What is the strength strength of that particularly soil during the construction? To do that, this quick test is required, and this quick test is nothing but your unconfined compression test, where you will get immediately SU is equal to C is equal to QU by 2.